गुड आफ्टरनून कन्नन सर।
गुड आफ्टरनून, हु स्पीकिंग?
आफ्टरनून सर, दिस इज डॉक्टर रवि फ्रॉम एमएनटी जयपुर। गुड आफ्टरनून सर, दिस इज डॉक्टर रवि फ्रॉम
गुड
एमएनटी।
आफ्टरनून सर।
So finally, I'm able to log in and I'm a panelist now. I'm
Yes,
also.
sorry sir. We had some
Why it's
technical
taken so much time? We should have planned it better, right?
yes sir.
So tell me when to start and then we can get started.
Sir, just a few minutes, sir. I think Saulo sir would
No
also like
problem. Take it. Let me know once you are ready.
Sir,
yes.
Yeah. So I didn't hear you. Are you saying that I should start?
Saulo sir, I'm fine, sir. I think we can.
So let me know once you're ready.
Yes, sir. Just 2 minutes, sir.
Yeah, Ravi. Good morning. Good morning. Good afternoon, sir. Madhavar sir. I am Vineet from Jaipur.
Hi, Vineet.
Yeah, good afternoon, sir. We actually changed panelist yesterday, so the link was deactivated.
I see.
Yeah, sorry for that delay. Ravi, Bharat, good afternoon.
Very good afternoon, sir. Very good afternoon, sir. Kannan, sir. Very good afternoon, sir.
Dr. Ravi.
Sir, we are sorry that because of this.
Yes, sir. Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah, Ravi. CV of sir, ka CV hai?
Sir, I just need to check.
Sir, I have the CD. I'm just taking the responsibility. Sir.
Sure, sure. Please, please. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Sir, good afternoon, sir. Kannan sir, with your permission, can we start?
Yeah, please go ahead.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Very good afternoon to participants. Today is the fourth day of this FDP, and I'm very happy and delighted to introduce our eminent speaker, Professor Kannan M. Professor Kannan is an Iraq and Mehta Education Technology Chair Professor at IIT Bombay. He received a BTech and PhD degree for his work in chemical engineering at IIT Madras and Rice University respectively. And he did master's in electrical engineering from the later part. He was a visiting professor at University of Alberta. He has written 4 textbooks and several papers in journals and conferences. He worked in the area of simulation, control, and education technology. Professor Kannan has been focusing on massive IT skill education through spoken tutorials, open source software, and affordable jobs. He is extending the spoken tutorial approach to other skill topics such as health, nutrition, and breastfeeding. He received the Google MOOCs Research Award for the offline capability in spoken tutorials. He was nominated for the HT for Mumbai 2015 award. The spoken tutorial project received the best prize in the Reimagine Education Award 2015 in the Nurturing Employment category. Recently, he was also awarded the Pandit Deendayal Upadhyay recognition for Re-Engineering India 2020. I am very happy, Professor Kannan, to have you here on this platform, and thank you for accepting our invitation. And now, sir, it is over to you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you for the introduction. Thank you for inviting me. It's a delight to address all the students. Let me share my screen. Okay, so the title I have given is Organizing Ideas, and also to talk about select LaTeX resources. So this is going to be the outline of my talk. There are two parts. The first one is on reports, presentations, etc. In this, I will talk about organizing thoughts. The same approach will work for reports, books, slides, writing a newspaper article, and so on and so forth. Every one of them, organizing the thoughts is extremely important, and then improving them and so on. I have maybe one or two slides on English writing. Then the second half, I'll talk about select LaTeX resources. Once again, two topics. One is LaTeX spoken tutorials, and then LaTeX MOOC from IIT Bombay X. You already know what MOOC is, Massive Open Online Course from IIT Bombay X. It's a MOOC platform from IIT Bombay. It's based on OpenEdX. So let me start with the first one, namely reports, presentations, etc. How does one organize the thoughts? Okay. So how does one do? I'm going to explain it with what I do. In fact, I followed this approach recently also to write a conference paper, and I had only 2 days to write the paper, and I could do a good job. The paper got accepted in this conference. Basically, first you throw in all the points as they come to your mind. I'm going to illustrate it with the example, with the actual case that I just mentioned. This is our accepted paper, a timed discussion forum for novice users and self-learners of spoken tutorials. This is what I created recently using the approach that I'm going to talk to you about. So this got accepted in the 9th International Conference on Interactive, Collaborative, and Blended Learning at McMaster University, Hamilton, Canada, 14th to 16th October 2020. Okay. By the way, I write a lot on papers. This paper is on spoken tutorial forums. Let me click this. So you will see, so basically we wrote a paper on this, okay? So what do I do? How does one organize the thoughts? How do I organize the thoughts? Just throw in all the points as they come to your mind, okay? So here is a paper. I always have a notebook and I write a lot. And before, I don't go to the computer straight away. So for example, this is McMaster paper. So these are some of the points. You may be able to see this. Need to promote open source. So I talk about spoken tutorial, many advantages, shortcoming about spoken tutorial. Then I say unfriendly because the forums are unfriendly, because they talk about top-down design and so on. Then I talk about forum timed. That is my solution. Whatever that comes to my mind, I just keep on throwing one after another, right? And then of course, as I write, if there is some set of ideas, I group them together. But these are not necessarily in any order, okay? So throw in all the points, then group the related ideas, okay? You've got a lot of things. In fact, throwing in the points, it may take quite a bit of time. Sometimes I even give 2 days for me to just keep thinking about what are the things that paper should cover. Go on adding that. So once again, this is all in this paper form only. So for example, I have collected all the ideas. Then I say, by the way, this is a short paper. As a result, that's the reason why it could be done in a short time. I could write the paper in a very short time. So I have collected all the ideas. Then I said, okay, let me start organizing them. So for example, here I said, wanted to have a friendly interface. Here I said that unfriendly, you know, in a different way I had written, but here I said, I have collected, now I'm going to group the ideas. I go through pick and choose, put them below. So wanted to have a friendly interface. Then I write why. I have to say why it is required. And the answer is only way to teach lots of people. And then I say, wanted to see if people can easily locate information. Okay, these are the reasons to have a friendly interface. So I start writing, grouping these based on things that may have been at different locations. Then I say that, and then I go on saying, wanted to see if useful content can come out, collaboration can actually help, but difficult. And then, so once I write about all this, then I say, okay, but we came up with a timed discussion forum. Whereas here, if you see, timed discussion forum came right in the beginning. I still talk about these over here. So in other words, initially, you don't have all the points. So you have to, it takes a little bit of time to put in all the things that you want to think about, you want to write about, you want to talk about. If you're giving a presentation also, same thing. Put in everything one by one, whatever that comes. Then you say, I'm going to group them. Okay, so I've done the grouping. As they come to your mind, group the related ideas. And then you have to make sure that the flow is smooth and logical. That, for example, you don't go back and forth. Okay, and it is logical. The second point comes from the first, and third point comes from the second, and so on and so forth. So all these things you should do only at the outline stage. By the way, this is the outline stage. We are still in the outline stage. All of this, I suggest you do at the outline stage itself. Don't start sitting before the computer and start typing. You do all this work before going to the computer, before writing your paper. Okay? You have to ensure the flow is smooth and logical. By the way, I call this, if you see here, this is for a short paper. Okay, I'll come to that. Now here, I'm continuing. Here I said problems. Okay, now I'm ready to, I'm more or less finalized on the flow. First of all, I say, wanted to see if people can easily locate information to get their doubts cleared and to learn. So students without help will also be benefited. Wanted to have a friendly interface to retain people in the open source environment. Okay, scolding people is not very good. Wanted to see if useful content can come out of interaction and so on. So in other words, now I have grouped all the things that I want. These are the things I want. Okay, and then collaboration I talk about. Then I say, we came up with a timed discussion forum. And what does it do? It is friendly, easy to locate. Every one of them, this one says unfriendly, then it is friendly. Difficult to locate, easy to locate. So this way, outline itself, I'm arranging all the things. Okay? And then I say that there are some also unexpected benefits. So now it doesn't happen in one go. You should be prepared to write the outline any number of times. It is a lot better than going to the report, typing the whole thing, and then trying to figure out whether the flow is okay or not. As a matter of fact, when I talk to my students, I say that unless you do the outline, I won't even look at your report. Okay? Sometimes they write the outline after writing the report. That's okay. I don't care about that. But I won't even look at the report. Okay? This is a lot better, a lot more efficient. Okay. Now, this is what I call organizing the thoughts. It's a short report. Okay? What I'm going to show you a short report. I told you that I wrote this paper in about 2 days. So it's a short paper. It had only some... I think 8 pages. So, but there are, you know, bigger ones that would take a lot more time. So in the case of short report, this is what I would do. Throw in all the points as they come to your mind. Group the related ideas. Ensure flow is smooth and logical. Write on paper and type. Of course, you have to divide them into sections, subsections, and so on. So that is implicit. Write on paper and type. Okay. Of course, this is my preference. I mean, some of you may not like to write. For me, if I sit before the computer, I can't think. So I prefer to write on paper, and then it is a lot easier. Then I don't have to worry about the formatting. Does it look nice? Is it centered? Is it bold? All those things I don't have to worry about. Just go on writing, right? So for example, I'm going to show you the material that I started writing. Okay. We have the following problems with respect to answering beginner's queries and documentation for open source. P1, unfriendly interface, unfriendly interaction. P2, reading before posting, and then so on. Okay, P3, constructing useful content out of collaboration. And then I start actually writing the paper. Okay. So I have written what are the problems? I've written all this. Okay. Then I start writing about how people, what are the existing solutions, how do we solve it, and so on. So here is our accepted paper. Let me I have already opened it here. So let me show it here. This is a McMaster paper. Okay. So for example, you can actually see that this is the paper we wrote. So desired features, remember this, friendliness, reading before posting, constructing useful content out of online collaboration. Now it follows the same because then it becomes very easy. Then implementation of the forum with desired features. Okay. Then it becomes very easy. Okay. So let me come back here. Now I'm going to talk about long report. What happens in the case of long report? That is a short report. Long report means there are a few other things that you have to do. Other things are the same. This is the new one. Details to various sub-levels. Then you have to say, I'm going to have section, maybe chapter, section, subsection. You can do that. At the time of writing the outline, I asked my students, tell me how many pages each of these will come. For example, you say, I have a chapter. How many pages will it have? So they will say, okay, it depends on sections. Okay, I ask, okay, how many pages each section will take? Then they say, okay, let's go to subsection. So finally, they'll be able to give for each subsection, half a page, one page, two page, and I add up and I say, okay, this chapter will take so many pages. I want them to think about and say, okay, this is what they have, because I cannot find out. I would not want them to write first and then I start asking them questions, scolding them or giving them advice and so on. In fact, will not be able to help them if they come up with a, let's say 100 page report. It'll be very difficult for me to go through it and solve it. So it is still in outline stage. In fact, I'm going to give an example of this, a pre-synopsis report of my PhD student and the outline that he came up with, okay? Now, this is extremely important. You make the sections approximately equal, approximately. Of course, it's possible that introduction section may be small, introduction chapter may be small. So if it is a journal article, then you have sections, subsections, subsections. If it is a report or a book in LaTeX, you will have chapter, section, subsection. So whatever it is, whatever the heading is, start from the top one. Every one of them at the same level should be about the same. For example, I often find out sometimes our students don't divide the things that they have to present suitably. It takes quite a bit of effort. Sometimes what happens is a subsection is bigger than a chapter. So you have chapter, you have a section, and you have a subsection. Now, if a subsection length is bigger than that of a chapter, what does it say? It says what you are going to write in the subsection is actually very important. You have so many things to talk about. Okay, maybe that should become a chapter. Whereas the chapter is actually smaller than a subsection. Maybe it should become a subsection. Rearrange. So this making the sections approximately equal is extremely helpful because it tells your advisor, it tells your guide, look, this is important to me. So the guide should say, then in that case, you make it a chapter. Why are you putting it inside somewhere? It should be prominently displayed as a whole chapter, right? So that comes out when you do this. So approximately equal, then you can understand the importance, how much importance you want to associate. The same thing happens for presentation. You have to tell, you have written all the ideas. There you have to say how many minutes you're going to talk about. So something is going to talk, you're going to talk about 10 minutes, another one only half a minute. Then why do you want to call something? Why do you even put it in the outline? You should put this in the outline. You should say, I'm going to talk about this. I'm going to spend substantial time on this, and so on. Okay. So this is extremely important. Ensure flow is smooth and logical. Okay. Of course, this is still there, but this is extra that you have to do. You have to do section, subsection, and so on. In fact, I asked my people, please, you know, you might have seen in textbooks, you have the whole book and you have the outline, the contents, for example. Contents page is there, table of contents. Supposing your guide tells you, write the table of contents first. You must write the table of contents first and put page numbers, approximate. At least say how much each one will take before you start writing the report, before you start writing the book. Because from the table of contents, I'll be able to understand. Okay. So I told you about my PhD student, Kiran, his pre-synopsis report. So I have a copy of it here. So let me just go there. Okay, this is his, let me make it bigger. Okay, so this was his PhD thesis, and then contents. By the way, this page, this is only 74 pages because it's only the content. Okay, the actual report was when he finished his pre-synopsis, which became the thesis. It became some 200 pages. Okay, so he talks about introduction, the literature review on CS programming education, educational design and research methodologies, assessment of student perception, and so on. So he writes all this. Now let me go to each of them. So these, of course, this was automatically generated by LaTeX because the table of contents, make title is there, table of contents is there. So I'm going to skip this. Okay. So this is chapter introduction. In that also, I ask people to write it in, you organize it, you put it in the bullet form. So you will have section 1.1, 1.2, you know, things like that, right? Then 2.1, 2.2, 2.3, things like that. So all of this you can see is just the outline. And what happens is, if you follow the approach that I'm talking about, you do a detailed outline. You say, I ask my students, tell me the chapters first. Okay, they write the chapters. I ask them, okay, what are you going to talk about? They just tell me in 1 or 2 minutes. Then I tell them, okay, give me the sections in that. They write 1.1, this, 1.2, this, 1.3, this. Then I try to, without them even writing the report, I spend some time with them. Okay, 1.1 is what? What are you going to write some subsections in that? Then 1.1.1, 1.1.2, 1.1.3, and so on. So they fill the whole thing. Then I ask them to fill the pages, number of pages, rearrange, check whether the flow is correct. All of them, I sit with them and do. By the way, they have not started writing the report yet. I ask them to do this before. Before doing all of this, I ask them to do. Once everything is figured out, the flow is figured out, the sectioning is figured out, what is a section, what is a subsection, what is a chapter is figured out, everything is perfect, then what happens is I tell the students, okay, go ahead and write it. You cannot make too many mistakes. Even if they make a mistake, that mistake will be localized. It could be in a subsection. Maybe in a subsection, you have 4 points, 4 bullet points. There, maybe you made a mistake. So no problem. It will not affect your whole report. And typically, if you follow this approach, any reviewer will say the flow is very good. The flow is very good by design. The flow is very good by design. That is why it is good. Okay. Okay. So that is for how I do the outlining. Now I'll talk about the sequence of writing. How do I do? I mean, this is this is one recommended methods, or one of the recommended methods. Start with the conclusion, move in the reverse direction progressively, but it is not hard and fast. You can move back and forth, and then introduction, and you write the abstract at the end. Okay, what is an abstract? It is a brief summary of what is done in the paper. It is not an introduction. It is not a status report. Don't write several pages. It can be very brief, as low as 4 sentences, for example. So, for example, let me show you the abstract that we wrote for this, our McMaster paper. Okay. So, what do I say? Spoken tutorials are an instructional methodology to train students on IT topics at a national level through self-learning. Why I say that? Because this whole thing is for spoken tutorials, this forum. Then I say problems that beginner users face in accessing information from online resources are explained. A timed online discussion forum through which... So basically, I'm saying, what is it we have done? It is not a status report. It is not an introduction. It has to be very brief, right? So that's what I meant. It can be very brief. It can be as low as 4 sentences, for example. The reader should figure out, based on the abstract, whether they want to read your paper or not. Okay? It is to the point. You explain what you are doing, what you have done in that. Okay? And you can say that how it is better than something else. Of course, you can say, this is better than what other people have done. And I have experimental work, I have theoretical work, I have simulation work, all kinds of things. You can say, but please restrict to what you have done. Okay? But it is brief. Abstract itself means brief. Okay, I want to take a little bit of time to talk about this, my famous, my very, a book that I like a lot. A book, you know, it's a fantastic book, Strunk and White. This book, by the way, is it was used to be available in Indian edition. Some versions of it is available on the net. By the way, the book is called, book is not Vigorous Writing is Commerce. That's not the topic. Actually, I wanted to write here, Strunk and White. The book is called Elements of Style. Elements of Style. Okay. So let's get on with it. What this author says, by the way, this was proposed by Strunk. He was an English professor in New York, and he probably wrote this in 1920s, okay? Maybe 1919, 1920, around that time frame. He says, vigorous writing is concise. A sentence should contain no unnecessary words. You go through every sentence that you have written, remove all unnecessary words. Similarly, a paragraph should not contain any unnecessary sentences. Remove all the unnecessary sentences. For the same reason that a drawing should have no unnecessary lines and a machine no unnecessary parts. So does a drawing have unnecessary lines? Does a machine have unnecessary parts? Doesn't have. Similarly, he says, a paragraph should not have unnecessary sentences and a sentence should not have unnecessary words. Remove all of them. Okay? Then he says, this requires not that the writer make all his sentences short, or that he avoid all detail and treat his subject only in outline, but that every word tell. Every word should say some story. Every word should convey something. Okay? So this is an amazing book, Strunk and White, Elements of Style. That's the name of the book. Okay? It's a fantastic book. Yeah, I suggest that you get hold of it. An earlier version of it is available. It's a very small book. It is also known as the little book. Okay. Now I go on to LaTeX, and these are the things that you would already know. It's like a programming language. Focus on ideas, not on presentation. Automatic numbering, referencing, great tool for paper writing, report writing. Also figures. By the way, that XFIG, the very first spoken tutorial, in fact, that I'm going to show is on XFIG. Okay. It's open source. You don't have to pay a single paisa for that, and it works on all platforms. At some point in time, I switched my complete book from Linux to Mac OS X, and all I had to do was, starting directory, my user directory was slash home. It was in slash home in Linux. Here it was slash users. That's the only change I had to make. Then it worked like a charm. The book worked beautifully. Similarly, you can take it to Windows and you don't have to identical margin. Everything will be exactly the same. Okay. So it's a fantastic thing. You don't lose out at all. In fact, I got the book by Leslie Lamport. In fact, by the way, it's a classic book. I'm sure somebody will refer to that. I brought that book when I visited my friend. In fact, I bought it in Georgia Tech bookstore. My friend was there. He said, Kannan, it's a great book. Friend is Saktivel. He said, Kannan, this is a great book. Why don't you buy it? So I bought that book. This I bought in 87. I still use it. I still use it. Can you believe it? This was before I joined IIT Bombay as a faculty member, right? So it's about 33 years old, 34 years old. Fantastic. Same book. No change. Okay. Basic things haven't changed. Of course, a lot of new things have been added. Okay, now I'm going to the second part of my talk, which is LaTeX resources. Spoken tutorial is the first resource I want to tell you about.
Welcome to the spoken tutorial on embedding mathematics in XFIG. In this tutorial,
look at this.
I shall explain how to create this figure.
Next one.
C++
we dub it in other languages.
Or destructors के spoken tutorial में आपका स्वागत है. इस tutorial में हम
spoken tutorial चा creating basic content वरील पाठात आपले स्वागत.
Flowsheeting के अरिमुगम कुरित spoken tutorial के नल वरवे.
Java इत्यस्मिन अंकगणितीय प्रक्रिया या पाठम प्रति स्वागतम.
To summarize, spoken tutorial is a 10-minute long audio video tutorial. It is created for self-learning. This is the most important thing. We guarantee that spoken tutorials are suitable for self-learning. Okay, that's what has made it very attractive, very popular. And I have a picture on this. And the audio is dubbed into 22 languages. Use some of them, downloadable for offline use. So we use the script, just like movies have a script. Our tutorials also have a script. Write a script, and we ask, can a beginner understand it? Most of the time, the answer is no. Then we say improve the script. Fortunately, it comes out of the loop, and we say yes, the beginner can understand. Then we record it, so it is created for self-learning. Because it can be used offline, we could conduct workshops for 250 people. By the way, this workshop was on LaTeX. In fact, we even wrote a paper on that, a massive self-learning silent LaTeX workshop. If you search on that IEEE conference proceedings, you will see that. Okay. Because it can be used offline, it can be used without electricity also. So long as the laptop is charged, you can do this. In fact, they had to wait for electricity to come to take this picture. This was in Myanmar, Burma. Another important thing, anyone who undergoes a spoken tutorial workshop can themselves teach other people. Okay? Because you don't teach anything, you learn yourself. So you just have to tell people how to learn using spoken tutorials that anybody can do. So if you've gone through a spoken tutorial workshop, you can definitely become a teacher. You can conduct workshops. Just imagine you do one workshop, then you can conduct that workshop. Fantastic, right? That is something you can do. So whether you're a teacher or a student, it doesn't matter. You can teach your colleagues, students, teachers, and so on. These are some of the tutorials, spoken tutorials we have on LaTeX on our webpage. All you have to do is to search for spoken tutorial LaTeX. It'll take you there. You'll see a Google search and tell you, so you can go there. So LaTeX on Windows using TechWorks, report writing, letter writing, mathematical typesetting, equations, numbering equations, tables and figures, Beamer, bibliography, feedback diagram with maths. I showed you that XFIG. New commands in LaTeX, new environments in LaTeX, writing style files in LaTeX, and Indic language typing in LaTeX, meaning Hindi, Bengali, Assamese, Tamil, Gujarati, Marathi, and so on and so forth. How does one do that typing in LaTeX? So all these tutorials are already available and available free of cost. Each one is about 10, some of them are a little longer, but they are typically about 10 minutes long. Okay, next one. So I told you about spoken tutorial. This is over. Now I'm going to talk about the second resource, LaTeX MOOC. You know what MOOC is? Massive Open Online Course through IIT Bombay X. Okay, through IIT Bombay X. Here is the link. If you want, you can take a snapshot shot of it. And in that, this is the IIT Bombay X website. This is the IIT Bombay X LaTeX course link. By the way, I say LaTeX, not LaTeX. Okay, that is because this is Kappa, not X. So this is LaTeX. So LaTeX course link is also here. Those of you who are interested, please take a screenshot of it, take a picture of this, and then it is available. Go and check all contact information. Everything is available. That course, this course is open now. Okay, and what is very interesting is this: the person who created that book, Firuza Karmali, she is a staff member in our project. She has even written an amazing book, A Short Introduction to LaTeX. Let me click that. This will take you to Amazon. There it is. Okay. So this is just 120. Length is only 96 pages. Actually, it is 120 pages, I think. But this book is available. You can see the ranking of this paper and what different reviewers are saying from India, from the other countries. Somebody from Canada says excellent introduction, and so on and so forth. Somebody from US says good introduction, and so on, right? So let me. So where are we? Okay, I'm not sure. I'm trying to look at my slides. Yeah. Okay, no problem. What I will do is using this, I guess I can show this. In fact, I've come to the end of my talk. So this project is funded by the National Mission on Education through ICT, funded Madan Mohan Malviya National Mission on Teachers and Teaching, Ministry of Education, Government of India. We have a lot of interesting things. I mean, I can talk about you know, some of the packages to use and things like that. So let me see if I can get back to the link. I think, are we here? I think I know what the problem is. We close this. Okay, let me stop sharing, then it'll become open. Yeah. So if there are questions, I'll be happy to answer those questions. I assume that I'll have to finish by 3, and I finished it fast. But if we have some time, I can actually explain some of the packages I use. Maybe that may be useful to some people. What do you think? We have still time. We have about 20 minutes.
Yes, sir, definitely. We can go with some packages.
Yeah. There is one question. Some questions are also there. I can answer them.
Sure, sir. Should I recite that? Yogesh Kumar
yeah,
said.
No, I can see it. Please repeat the name of the reference book, right? Name of the reference book. Let me point out two references. So, this is one book. So, let me show you another book. One book. And then this is. Leslie Lamport. Okay. So this is an amazing book, LaTeX by Leslie Lamport. It's available in Indian edition. It's only 200 rupees. It's an amazing book. This is what I told you I bought in Georgia Tech when I went to meet my friend in 87. Okay. So that's what it says. This book written by the original architect and implementer of LaTeX is both the user's guide and reference manual for the software. So these are two books that I have. This is written by one user. She's the one, Firuza, who's she's one of our staff members. She has written this amazing book. And in fact, she's the one who has created that MOOC course also, right? So these are the two books. So how did I get here? I did a search. Leslie Lamport, LaTeX. Leslie Lamport, LaTeX, and buy LaTeX book online at low prices in India. It is only 200 rupees. Okay. I suggest that get hold of this. It's only 200 rupees. Okay. It's a very nice book. Okay. So what other question is there? Can't see my screen. Oh, sorry. I forgot to share my screen. One second. Okay. Yeah. So what I did was I searched by Leslie Lamport, LaTeX. Name of the person is this here, Leslie Lamport. Okay. I said Leslie Lamport, LaTeX, LaTeX. And then it gave all these search results. And here is the one, buy LaTeX book online at low prices in India in Amazon.in. Don't go to Amazon.com because this is an international edition. It's very expensive. But this is only 200 rupees. So if you click this, it'll go to the next page. This is what it is. Okay. The international edition is, this is the international edition. Leslie Lamport, notice that it is 2000 rupees. Whereas this is only 200 rupees, 1/10 the price. And it's an official copy. It's not a pirated copy. So you can go and use it legally. Okay. So this is something that I wanted to see. Okay, let me see what other question is there. Okay, how do I? Okay, is there any other question? Can you please tell me how to make presentations in LaTeX? So somebody says, how to make presentations? So it is in this spoken tutorial. Spoken tutorials on LaTeX, I told you. There is a tutorial on Beamer, okay? So that is going to be helpful. Let me show you that on our webpage. By the way, I don't know whether I showed you the links for I forgot to, let me just finish this and then I will show you the links. Then we come to LaTeX spoken tutorials. Let's go to LaTeX. Then English. Search. So this is, you have all the tutorials available. Notice that I have not even logged in. That's why it is saying login. It is saying login because I have not logged in. Okay, so you don't have to log in to access this material. So I told you Beamer. Outline Beamer, creating a presentation using Beamer. So you can listen to it.
Welcome to this spoken tutorial on presentation using LaTeX and Beamer. Let me first explain the arrangement that.
So this is something that I created. How to create a presentation using this. Of course, this turned out to be a little long, 34 pages, but everything, quite a bit about this is available here. Of course, to understand this, you'll have to go through some of the earlier ones also. Okay? So that is the thing. Yeah, so I have answered you, I hope. You can actually see that. Now, there are some more links I had, I forgot to show you. I forgot to click, in fact. For example, IIT Bombay X website. If you click this, it'll take you here. This is IIT Bombay X. Infinite learning opportunities. And that is why this X looks like infinity. And then IIT Bombay X LaTeX course link. If you click this, it'll take you to this. Okay, LaTeX for students, engineers, and scientists. Click here for enrollment process. And then course start July 15th. Although it started 15, it's a self-paced course. You can still catch up. You can still register. You can still do this course. Course end November 15th. It might even get extended. And about 3 to 4 hours per week. This is what you have to spend. And this is a good course. So you can follow either one of them. If you want help and so on, you can do that. By the way, in Spoken Tutorial also, you have help. Remember, I told you about the forums. I explained the first part using the forum. So here is the forum. Okay. So let me close this. So somebody says, please share the package you use in LaTeX. What package do I use? Oh, okay. I use a lot of packages. Let me see. Let me tell you about maybe one or two. But before that, let me point out the forums, how you can get help and so on. So the forum is, you have topic on which you can ask a question, name of the tutorial. By the way, this forum is for Spoken Tutorial. If you use Spoken Tutorial, you have a question in it in tutorial 3 at 5 minutes, 42 seconds, you can ask the question. Okay. So for example, let's say you have a question on LaTeX. So how do I find all the questions? Let me search and say, let's say LaTeX. Okay, all the LaTeX questions are there. Okay, all the questions on the Spoken Tutorials that people have asked. And then these also come as tutorials. Supposing I have a question on report writing. So next to report writing, there is a lens. If I click this, only questions asked on report writing will come. See this? And then, of course, this comes in some haphazard fashion. So I sort it according to time. Then what happens is all of them get arranged chronologically. Okay. All the questions from 0 to 1 minute are here. All the questions 1 to 2 are here. 2 to 3 are here. 3 to 4 are here. 4 to 5 are here, and so on. So you can click any of them. For example, here. Geometry style not found. Okay, he says LaTeX error, file geometric style not found, trying to install, but it shows proxy server ID and password. And it gives the error. The answer, please see the first tutorial on the series and learn about installing missing packages. Only when internet is available can you install new packages. If you cannot solve the problem using the method given above, an easy solution to do is to do a web search and locate the geometry.sty file and copy it in the current directory. That's an easy solution. Some package is missing, you copy it and put it in the current directory. It's not the most elegant method, but it'll work. By the way, I have answered this, right? So let me tell you about the package that I use. Let me see if there is any other question. Otherwise, I can go to the packages. One of the packages I use a lot is how to list a computer code. It could be a C program, it could be a Java program, it could be a Scilab program. By the way, we have a Scilab workshop coming soon. I think the deadline, we still have 1 week Scilab beginner workshop. So I would encourage all of you to join in that. So supposing you want to list Scilab code as a part of your thesis. I want to know, okay, supposing you want to include a MATLAB code. How do you do that? Can somebody tell me? You have to write a report. Let's say your MTech report or even your progress report, whether it is BTech, MTech, PhD, it doesn't matter. It could be your pre-synopsis report. It doesn't matter. Tell me how do you normally include the MATLAB code in your report? Can somebody tell me? Yeah, tell me over chat so that I can see it. How do you do that? So use the verbatim environment. Okay. So verbatim environment means you have to say begin verbatim, end verbatim, right? That means now this has become part of that. So now you have two copies. Okay. You have a program and you have a copy of it in your thesis, in your report. But tomorrow, supposing you change the code, but forgot to change, you know, put it inside and verbatim, it won't get reflected. Not only that, verbatim may give it in a, you know, particular different font and so on. So there are many problems. Main thing is you will maintain two copies. Some people use verbatim, some people use it as a doc file, copy paste it, right? Just copy paste it, use verbatim, not use verbatim, and so on. But there is a nice thing called listings. Okay, let me see if I can show you how I do that. The easiest thing is to do this in each course. UG control, we go there, we go to 2017. Okay, CD new Scilab. I'm not sure what is in this. Okay, I don't want to do this. CD 2016. Let's go to Scilab. Okay, my Scilab code is here, but yeah. So let's go to exams. I think that's good. So I have all the things. So let me see if I can open nsem.pdf. Okay, this is the exam that I set. I have to see where I have a Scilab code. Maybe I have it in the midsem. Open midsem.pdf. Okay. So let me just see. And okay. So what I will do is this has only solution, only answers. So I'll say Emacs midsem.tech and so I have something called Eat Ants. What it does, this is another package. I don't have time to explain. So I cannot tell how I have written that. But supposing I comment it, then I say PDF LaTeX midsem. It'll compile and it'll give me the solution also. Now the solution also is part of it. Okay. Yeah. In fact, what I can do is this also doesn't have one. Actually, there is something else I can show here, namely how I do Eat Ants, how do I keep question and answer together, and how do I present it? But that would mean I have to talk to you about defining new commands. And defining new commands is probably not covered yet, so I will not be able to explain that now. So let me see if I can CD exams. Once again, open in one of them, actually, I have given internal model control. Here it is. Draw an approximate root locus plot. Okay, I think this one has. So let's go to emacs.mitsem.tech. So for faculty members, it is extremely useful to keep the question and answer together. Okay. LaTeX, MITSEM. Oops, I think I commented something else. Okay, eat question also. I should comment eat answer. Okay, here is the Scilab code. Look at the Scilab code. This is the Scilab code I have used. Here it is. Okay, in fact, I have another Scilab code. Okay, now how do I include it? So I'll just show the text file, tech file, you will know, source file. So I just have to say, okay, look at this. This is the command I used. List input listing, MID, mid semester, root locus 1.se. Now, where is it? It's here. midrl1.se. So let me open that. More midrl1.se. That's it. So now what I do is I keep this file separately and I say it is in this folder. Whenever you want, you take it. So whenever I compile it, it'll go and fetch it. So you have only one copy of it available to you. Now, how do you, so this is the command, list input listing. In fact, if you know, you can find out all about it, but I will show you the command that I use, the package, use package command. Use package. Okay, these are all the things. Let me see. Here it is. Use package listings. So this package is called listings. If you use the package listings, then you can easily find out. And of course, how does one, supposing you say that half the time is, half the problem is solved if you know what package to use. So let me just show you Stack Exchange is something I use. There it is. How can I typeset Julio code with whatever? Listings package. Okay. So it's a how to use listings package. How to use listings package. Then if you go to Stack Exchange, how can I use the listings package with more than one? Whatever. Okay. So yes, he has given this. Here he says, I have SAS and then R. Various things. Of course, this is a more complicated one. It'll take a little bit of time to find out how to do that. Here is something, basic usage of listings package. Somebody has written, you know, how to do this and so on. So listings package is extremely useful and it is something that you can keep, you need to have only one copy. Anytime you need to have more than one copy, you are getting into trouble. Because which one are you maintaining? Which one are you modifying? Which one are you including in the report? So this is something definitely I wanted to talk about. The other one is Xfig, X-F-I-G. In fact, we have LaTeX spoken tutorials also. That is nice because you can embed symbols. For example, let me just show you that and then I will end my talk. So this is the book, Digital Control, that I wrote. And so if you see, let me go to chapter 9. Chapter 9, pole placement controller. So, pole placement controller. So here, look at this. Look at all the symbols. This is LaTeX. A super G, T sub 1, similarly Z to the power minus K. All of them I got embedded in Xfig. So Xfig works nicely with LaTeX, and it works only on, unfortunately, I think it works only on Linux. Okay.
Sorry, it is not visible.
It's not, sorry? You're not able to see it?
It is visible.
Not visible?
Now it is visible, sir.
Now it is visible? Okay.
Yeah.
Look at this. This is what I meant. So how to put the box and so on, Xfig you can do. But how to embed this, I have spoken tutorials. I have explained. Okay. Whatever LaTeX symbol you want, you can put it in Xfig, create a picture, feedback diagram, whatever you want, and then produce a PDF file and embed it. By the way, I created LaTeX spoken tutorials because I wanted my students to use LaTeX for their thesis. MTech, PhD students, I got tired of telling them every year, teaching them every year, year after year, teaching them LaTeX. I said, I will once and for all create spoken tutorials, done. All the things required for a PhD thesis, even to write books, good enough over there in our spoken tutorial. So I think I'm running out of time. I'll stop sharing. Are there some restrictions on listings in Beamer? Well, first write on a regular document, no? First try list input listings. By the way, it is listings, not list listings. Simple listings or list input listing, okay? So just search for listings package, then you'll find it. And first write it in a simple document. Write it in a simple document, and then it's straightforward. There are many examples. If you just do search a little bit, you will find it. There are thousands of packages, such packages available. And typically, it is useful to have a club, LaTeX club. All people who use LaTeX, and then you ask a question, two, three people try to find out, somebody finds it. So today you find an answer to a problem, and tomorrow you become an expert in that. You make a note of it. You make a copy of it. You say useful commands LaTeX. Write all of them. Keep storing them. Tomorrow, if somebody asks, they will come and ask you. You tell them. So similarly, if the other person is also doing, you ask them, they will tell you. So this is what the community learning is about. And this is what happens in open source software. Okay. So with that, I think I will end my talk. I hope you found some of it useful. And maybe on some other occasion. But go through the resources that I showed you, LaTeX spoken tutorials. It is good enough to learn LaTeX. And in fact, if you learn using that, you can also teach your students using that. And the IIT Bombay X, the MOOC thing that I talked about, you can learn at your pace. And of course, Firuza will be available to help you. Both are nice. You can do that and use our forum. For spoken tutorial forum, you can ask questions. And I also talked about outlining how you can become efficient in writing and how you can write a report without bugging your guide, and how a guide can tell their students so that the guide can spend just a little bit of time. I don't spend too much time with my students, but yet they end up producing good reports. So that is because of this outlining that I explained. So with this, I'll end my talk. Thanks for listening to me, and maybe we'll meet some other time.
Yeah, thank you very much, sir. I think we only wish that we could have announced time with you along the week. But so thank you very much, sir, for agreeing to join the participant group. And thanks for excellent talk and initiating us in many other things.
Thank you. Bye.
Thank you, sir. Vineet, sir?
Hello.
Hi, yes.
Yeah, good afternoon,
Vineet, sir, is here.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. So do we start or do we give a 5-minute break? Or?
No, I think the break happens only after your talks. Not at all.
Okay.
We'll take the break okay. after.
Yes. Yeah. So I will share my presentation.
Yes, you can share.
So how do I do that?
We just need 2 minutes to let participant know of your arrangements.
Okay.
Ravi, are you going to do it?
Yes, sir.
Sure. Thank you very much.
With your permission, Yogananda sir, I'll introduce our participants.
Yeah.
Professor Yogananda. Ravi, Professor
your mic Yogananda. Close to you. Your voice is slightly.
Professor C.S. Yogananda earned his PhD in mathematics from University of Madras in 1990. And after holding various positions in the Institute of Mathematical Sciences at Chennai and at Punjab University, at Indian Institute of Science Bangalore and Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, he is presently professor and head at the Department of Mathematics, SJCE, Mysore. He has held many honorary positions, including that of the Leelavati Trust in Bangalore and honorary joint director of Jawaharlal Nehru Planetarium at Bangalore. And he's also the chairman of the Tech Users Group of India. And he also holds many editorial responsibilities. He was the founding editor of Samasya, which is a triannual high school journal devoted to problem solving and mathematics. And he is a member of the editorial board of Resonance, a monthly journal of science education published by the Indian Academy of Sciences. And he has also been involved with Mathematical Olympiad movement in India since 1989. He was the deputy leader of the India team in the 36th IMO, which was held in Toronto. And he was the deputy leader of the India team in the 39th IMO, which was held in Taiwan in 1998. And apart from that, he has published several research and review articles in many journals, mostly on mathematics and mathematical olympiads. So we welcome you, sir. And over to you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. How do I share a presentation? Yeah. Share option.
At the bottom row, you
yeah.
have to unmute, start video, and third one is share.
Yeah, but that is not highlighted. That's why I was wondering. So what could be the problem?
You are presenter, sir. I think it should be doable.
It says.
Sir.
It is not highlighted. So,
it is not highlighted.
Yeah.
Ravi.
Yes, sir.
Ravi, can we toggle the presenter status for him two times? Because sir is not getting that highlighted share.
Yes, sir, I'm doing it.
Yeah. Thank you.
Sir, can you try again? Sir, please try again.
I don't know why it's not getting highlighted. I'm clicking on it now.
Usually, sir, it will be same color background white with which mute, unmute, start video. It is there.
Yeah, I get mute, start video I'm getting.
Okay,
and
sir.
this is not highlighting. Then,
so which link you have joined with?
Okay. Yeah, I just played one which came in the afternoon. Should I log out and join again?
Maybe, sir. Maybe we can. Sorry for the trouble.
Yeah. No idea. I just.
Sir. I'll make him yeah. host. I think he can then try it.
Okay, let's try one that.
Thank you.